If customers stay at that hotel?
Oh, no, that's not a hotel, Nathaniel. Oh. That's just condominium over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, I remember it was a condom.
Oh, yeah, it's real. You've really done a lot.
They used to have cottages over there.
You put $2 million in just the infrastructure of the seawall here.
Yeah.
The pilings are 30 foot in the ground. And then there's a piling on 6 feet right here where the traveler parks. The big boats that we haul out. And my first day here 3 years ago had the old metal piers.
Yeah. Oh, I bet it was. Because everything needed to. I mean, Bob should have
done something.
He bought the property and just let it. I mean, we were really pretty good with maintenance and all that. That original was still doing good. Although
that's still running.
Is it?
Yeah. Marine Travel Lift took it in on trade-in, actually.
Uh-huh.
We bought this, and it went to Honduras.
Oh, cool.
So it's living in Honduras now.
I'll tell Dan. He's going to kick out of that.
I'll tell you what, why don't you, I'll walk out of the other car, I'm sure. Why don't you send me an email one day when you have time, and I'll have your contact info.
Sure.
We're happy to, like, maybe if we have a question one day. Or...
Oh, yeah, he's totally retired, but he gets calls every week from somebody about something. Some boat that he's built, or some boat they want another one, which you can't do, but don't you know?
So the next goal is to complete the whole lot.
Oh, that'll be great. When we bought this property, we were partners with Cable Marine out of Fort Lauderdale, and they wanted to develop something over here. And we kept our sailboat. It's not there anymore either, but there used to be a marina right up, a little, like a trailer park that had a little marina behind it. We had our sailboat there. And we were looking all over, everywhere for property. And this was nothing. There was nothing here at all. It was just a beach with some strip boats that were like up on the beach. Right. Yeah, that's what we started with.
So we just got the permitting. We're dredging the entire facility.
Oh, you got permitting for that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's going to be 8 foot deep at mean low tide.
Oh, that's great. Because
right now I have 20 foot of water at the entrance to the travel lift.
Wow, that's fantastic. We did do some dredging too, and we got permitting for it, but they wouldn't give us anything close to that. And we had to, he was just a little thing. We had to go over there, which made a ton of sense. We had to go over there in the mangroves with our skiff and mitigate 250 mangroves, plant them. And then we had to keep a record of them.
We had to plant some over here when we did the seawall.
Yeah, yeah. It's so ridiculous. Like, they really need some.
Like more.
Yeah, they need more of them. Exactly. After enough, and the thing is, after about 2 or 3 years, nobody can even out of there.
Right. Wood screws and stuff for wooden boats. It was pretty neat.
Yeah, I
this is NOA Marine.
Did you guys put this in?
Yeah.
How old is this?
We put that in probably right around 2000, between 2000 and 2005.
What we're thinking about doing is cutting it.
Uh huh.
Extending it so we can drive the travel lift underneath.
That's great. What we put it there for originally was.
The contract with the police department, and he was repaying
You know what? Let me just...
It really pleases me to see how well you're taking care of it.
We really are. I mean, this property, it's not huge, but it's ours. And...
Yeah, and you can do a lot on this piece of property when you have a big lift.
I found that spot right there is really good to put the big 80 footers because it kind of tucks them right there. But it does get tight
right up in here.
Bit.
Yeah.
How did you guys propose? We tried dangling them.
I used to manage this place. Kind of still do.